from.
Yeah, so we use a dairy that's local right in town. We get all our cream and milk comes directly from them. We have to get it, you know, on demand, like fresh with cow in the morning. You know, so we're able to get it.
Oh, that's awesome. So
it works out really well.
Yeah,
and it's a high fat content. They use Jersey cows, so it's like the best cream we can get.
Yeah.
So once everything gets we're done in this room, we kind of move into this room. This is our cold side of the kitchen. We did a couple of these are pecan caramels that we use. It's a this is going to be a dark chocolate. It's a caramel with pecans and then topped with dark chocolate. And we're using this cutter to cut it into squares, individual squares to be enrobed, coated in chocolate.
Those are like marble tables?
Yeah, we use marble in here. We find that it distributes the heat best and cools down the quickest. So it works really well for us. And we've been using marble for as long as we've been here. So once we're done in here, we move on to our enrober room. And this is where things get coated in chocolate and the finished product. This line is our linen cream that we made this morning. So it gets extruded, get bottoms put on it, the bottom gets coated with chocolate.
So that just keeps flowing.
We have this cooling system here that gets the chocolate just about peppered. And here we're putting hand string on the linen cream. A lot of hands-on stuff.
Yeah.
The turtles here.
That's pretty intensive.
Yeah. So depositing the bottom and the top of it. We used to do it all by hand, funneled for years, but we got a little smarter. And she's taking the sea salt on the sea salt caramel from the back on the milk line.
So you have three different varieties going at once on any given day, or?
We do. I mean, we have our milk line, our dark line, and we have a center line that we can do different things on. So we can do hand place things that don't get coated in chocolate. We have a portable enrober that we can do white chocolate and things like that that we can set up down the middle. I pretty much would keep this a dark line and a milk line. And then from there, all three go into cooling tunnels. So it's all based on the residence time, how long they need to be in these cooling tunnels so the chocolate's completely set like it's on the other side. And here we got our lemon creams coming out.
Oh, so it's all hand-packed.
Yeah, all hand-packed, yeah. And the center. Not quite as busy this time of year, but still busy enough. Yes, we have two different milk pumps. We have a dark and we have a white, all set up with pumps. We can pump into individual molds and coolers.
You guys just had what's Super Bowl? Is Easter, Mother's Day?
Christmas,
you know,
Easter, yeah. Christmas, Valentine's Day, and the big three. Looks like probably at your place. So we're going to use this, our large 40, and this is our packaging room. So this is where we do a lot of our packaging and sealing and different things of that nature.
So we have all of our boxes here ready to go. We take them here, we put them on our belt. These are three-layer truffles. These are like, we make more of these than anything.
Three-layer truffles?
Yeah, German. Okay. They're just phenomenal.
Good.
So, which is really good. So you go to a lot of your other local businesses that you do business with?
We do. So it predominantly has been, you know, farmers in the beginning.
Okay.
And now we're trying to get out more to, you know, some of our other partners and manufacturers.
Sure.
And so one.
We're the first out.
Of
think so. Oh, yeah.
Well, we're not really being crazy.
Well,
yeah, in the bakery section.
In her, yeah,
we have
in
our
her,
wonderful, whole wonderful section. So
yeah.